In this example, it is saying that a metal body weighs W naught at temperature T1 in air, and when submerged in a liquid of density rho L, it weighs W1 at temperature T1 and W2 at temperature T2. And if a coefficient of cubic expansion of metal is gamma m, we are required to find the coefficient of cubical expansion of liquid. Now here we need to use the direct relationship between apparent weight and real weight when a body is submerged in a liquid. So we can say at temperature T1, we know that the apparent weight W1 in a liquid when a body is submerged, it can be given as W0 multiplied by 1 minus density of liquid upon density of solid, which is in this case a metal body. So, this is the relation between W1 and W0. And similarly, if we talk at temperature T2, the weight is changed to W2, which can be given as W0 1 minus densities of both liquid as well as that of metal will change, which can be written as rho L upon rho M, again multiplied by 1 plus gamma M delta T upon 1 plus gamma L delta T. Where delta T is the rise in temperature. Here we can write delta T is equals to T2 minus T1. Now, in this situation, if we substitute the value of rho L by rho M from this expression into it, you can see here rho L upon rho M can be written as W0 minus W1 upon W0. If we substitute it here, you can see we can write W2 is equals to W0 1 minus rho L by rho M. And instead of rho L by rho M, we can replace it by this. So, it can be written as W0 minus W1 by W0 multiplied by the same term 1 plus gamma M delta T upon 1 plus gamma L delta T. And if we simplify this relation and we take this terms of gamma on one side, we can see we'll be getting 1 plus gamma M delta T by 1 plus gamma L delta T is equal to, this can be written as W0 minus W2 upon W0 minus W1. On simplifying this directly, we can write the value of gamma of liquid, which can be written as W0 minus W1 upon W0 minus W2 multiplied by 1 plus gamma M delta T minus 1. So, this is the result we are getting for the coefficient of cubical expansion of liquid. So, this will be the answer to our problem.